Hi friends, this is Shiva. Today we are going to discuss about Selenium interview questions part 1. So I am going to share multiple video on this. So we will start with 10 questions. So continuously I am going to share multiple questions on Java, Selenium, TestNG and testing related concepts, right? So we will start with the first question. So the first question is, what kind of exceptions you have faced in the Selenium? See, basically whenever we are going to automate any functionality, we may see some issues, right? So some of the situations we are not worrying about those exceptions, but when you come to interview, you should be very clear about some exceptions. No need to know about all the exceptions. You should remember any 5 or 4 or 3. So when you can able to explain those exceptions, so that it will be very easy for you to clear the interview. The first one is web driver exception. So basically it's a common exception. See, when after closing the browser, still web driver is looking for the element, right? So it's trying to access the browser. So those kind of situations, this exception will occur. The second one is session not found exception. So sometime what we will do, when by mistake we will quit the browser so in this kind of situations your session will be closed, but still web driver trying to access some element, right? So those kind of situations this exception will occur, right? So element not visible exception, this always will happen. This is a common exception everybody will get, right? So sometimes what will happen when we hover the any element, so like there is a drop down, you are trying to access that top level menu. So when you hover on that menu, automatically the drop down should appear, and from the drop down you are going to click some element, right? So if that element is not available to click, automatically there's an exception called element is not visible exception will occur, right? And no such frame exception, this is a similar one, like when we are trying to switch from top level page to some frame. So anyhow, we know that what is a frame, right? So there is a web page is divided into several pages, right? So those pages are covered inside the frame, so there is a difference, right? So the page will be divided into several frames, right? So every frame will act as the one web page. So simply you cannot access the element inside the frame. So what we need to do, from the top level page we need to come inside that frame and we need to access it. Sometime when you're trying to move that frame, you cannot get that frame. So those kind of situations it will say no such frame exception. Then no such window exception. When we are trying to work with multiple browsers, and when you are accidentally you have closed some tab, so or accidentally you have closed some window, so when you are trying to move that same window, that window is not available, you cannot go inside. Those kind of situations it will display no such window exception. It is similar to no such frame, like because it's not available when you are trying to access, right? So these are the 5 exceptions. So again there are others also, is there no alert present exception. So you can remember some similar exception and you need to explain when it will occur, then how you will resolve. So those things you can able to explain. Then second one is stale element reference exception. So initially what is stale element reference exception? So this is a common interview questions, we can whenever you are going to attend the interview, this is the common question. So when you are trying to access any element, due to that element, like you are trying to click on element, so once you clicked, that page got refreshed or something happening inside the page, you are not able to locate any element. So the element is available in the DOM, but you are not able to click it due to something happened, like that that's it. So what happened? So which means that action is affected that element. So WebDriver is lose the connection with that element. So automatically what will happen is, so the WebDriver is not able to access the element which is available in the DOM. So automatically it will throw the stale element reference exception. So due to some actions, you are not able to access that element. So this will happen. So how we can resolve it? So there are two things. Once you that action, when you click that element, that action is happening, right? So what we can do is, we can locate the same element again, because already that WebDriver is lose the connection, right? So you need to create the connection with the element. So automatically you can able to access that element. So the first one. So we can find that element again. The second thing is, we can use the fluent wait, because some of the situations the element are very dynamic. For example, that element is available only for the 2 seconds, and after 5 seconds the same element will appear. So what we can do is, every 5 seconds we can find that element. If the element is available, then we can click it, right? So instead of using the WebDriver wait, we can use the fluent wait. So that's what I'm trying to say here. So every 5 minutes, every 5 seconds, that element is available, right? So we can use the poll out for each and 5 seconds, and we can find that element. If it is available, you can perform action. So those kind of situations, you know, this stale element reference exception will appear, right? So hope you can understand this question answer. The third one is runtime, how the polymorphism is achieved in Selenium. Okay, so there are two kinds of polymorphism is available: compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. So basically, the compile time polymorphism, in the sense, the method parameters are identified during the compile time itself, and runtime polymorphism, in the sense, that method parameters are identified during the runtime based on the type of the object. So this is the common concept. So anyhow, the same concept I will explain in Java also, but we are focusing now Selenium. So how we are going to achieve this compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism in the Selenium? This is the question here. So I have taken some simple example to explain during the interview. Okay, so first I am explaining where we are using the method overloading in the Selenium. So if you see here, driver dot send keys of hello world, right? So the same method name, one parameter, and driver dot send keys of, so here not driver, it should be element, right? So it must be element. So element dot send keys of hello world, along with I am sending one more text called enter, right? So now the same method name, different number of parameters. So hello world along with the keys dot enter. So we are using regularly, but when we come to the interview, we will forget it. Right? So the preparation always will make us good, right? While attending the interview. So where we are using the automation framework, like when we are working with the automation framework, how we are achieving that? So what we can do is, here I am using different example. So in framework, I have created two methods. So whenever I want to click the element, I can send the element directly. That is one first method. That second one is the same method with the different parameter. I can send the locator, like xpath or id or name. So I will send it there. So inside the method, I will create the xpath, right? So there are two things I can able to say here. So this is method overloading, and this is method overloading in the Selenium, right? So these are the two examples you can say. So whenever you are trying to explain elaborately, right? So automation level and Selenium level, so that you will get more good idea. You will get, so that interviewer will come to know that, okay, this guy knows more things, right? So those kind of situations we need to create. while attending the interview. Then runtime polymorphism. How we are achieving runtime polymorphism in the Selenium and automation framework, right? So some of the sets, it's very rare when we apply runtime polymorphism in the framework, but still, if the interviewer asks you to how you can create, right? I have one example for that also. So here, everybody is familiar with the Chrome options, right? So Chrome options option equal to new Chrome options. So here, if you see here, same method name, and same arguments, right? So here also I'm sending the string. Here also I'm sending the string. So type of the object, it will identify the method. It will add that into the arguments. Say this option object, right? So same method name. Basically, what is runtime polymorphism? Same method name with the same signatures. Both are available in the base class and derived class, right? So here what we are doing is, anyhow, we are having the same method name and same arguments, same method name and same arguments. Here we are not going to use any type of arguments, right? So we can take this as an example for the method overriding for the runtime polymorphism. In test automation framework, we can say that there is a class called base page. So this is my, like people are very familiar with the test base, right? You can take like that. So now all the test script is going to extend this page, or all you can take like that. Every page object's class is going to extend this class, right? Okay. So there is one constructor. It has some parameters, right? So name equal this dot name equal to name, this dot it equal. So these are the parameters I'm sending from the page object test script, right? Or page object, you can take anything. So we are going to focus on method overriding. So in my base class, I'm having the method called isDisplayed, right? And I'm having one more class called home page, extend the base page, right? So when you call super dot is displayed, it will call the base class is displayed method, right? So which means that we are having is displayed method in both base class and the derived class. You see here, both base class and the derived class. Okay. Now if I want to call this method, I need to create object for the particular class and I can call it, right? So this is what we can implement, right? So what you can do is, I have one you can explain like that. So during the interview, if they ask the question, so I'm going to create one base class for all the page objects, and every page object is going to extend that page object. So when the page object is going to extend the page object, I am going to have two methods. I am going to implement the two methods in the two classes. Like you can say that isDisplayed. So isDisplayed is going to, I am going to write the both base class and the derived class. Like we have created isDisplayed, right? So automatically when the derived class, if I call isDisplayed method, super dot is displayed. So automatically this will call the method from the base class. And when you want to create particular displayed method, I can create object for the particular class and I can call the is displayed method, right? So this is the way you can explain, right? So here also we are implementing runtime polymorphism, and this is one of the important questions: Selenium architecture, or how the WebDriver commands are converted into Selenium scripts are converted into browser commands, right? So here I have shown the architecture of Selenium. Basically, this Selenium client libraries, we can say C, C++, Java, C#, that languages. Client libraries, and this JSON wire protocol, it's acting as the transporter. Like if you see here, I have given the example, right? So representational state transfer. So it is transferring the Selenium commands. So it is the Selenium commands from the Java or any programming language is converted into HTML client request and response. So these requests are given to this wire protocol, JSON wire protocol, and this sends to the browser driver, and this from the browser driver, the HTML web server will receive those requests, and that will manage the real browser. Once the test scripts are executed, again it will send as the response to the JSON wire protocol, and that will send to the Selenium client libraries. Like if you use Java, then you will get the test result, right? So this is the way. Sometime they will expect this JSON wire protocol. So all the Selenium command from any language is converted into HTML request. So those HTML requests are transferred from libraries to the browser drivers using JSON wire protocol, and web server will receive those commands from the browser drivers, and that web server will manage the actions in the browser, the real browser. Finally, it will send back to the result to the our Selenium script, like your programming language. So this is the way you can explain. So here I have that four steps, you can use it. So HTTP request is generated and it is delivered to the browser driver for every Selenium command using the JSON wire protocol. So this is what I shown above, right? Those here, sorry. So the second point is the HTTP request is received by the driver through HTTP server. So all the steps or instructions to be executed on the browser is decided by the HTTP server. So this is going to execute your script. And finally, that execution result is sent back to the automation scripts. So this is the structure we are following, right? Okay. Have you used interface in your Selenium automation framework, right? So basically, the higher end frameworks will must have the Selenium interface. Basically, what is interface? So interface is going to have final variables and abstract methods, right? So we are going to create all Selenium methods inside the this interface, Selenium WebDriver interface, right? And we are going to create one more class called Selenium interface, which is going to implement the Selenium WebDriver, which means all the method definitions we are going to write inside. Anyway, you know, when the class implements the interface, so all the abstract methods should be implemented inside the interface. So now your page objects will use these methods from the this Selenium implementation class. So I have created one demo for this thing, how we can implement the Selenium interface during the in the test automation framework. So when you go to my channel, you can able to see how to implement interface test automation framework using the page object method. So this will help you to create the framework using the structure, like when you, if you want to implement interface in your automation framework, how you can implement. So I have given some idea how to create it, so you can use this video to implement that concept, right? Okay. So have you called multiple methods in same line in Selenium, right? So how will you call multiple methods? So anyhow, we have a class called actions. So action dot move to element. So here it must be small, right? So action dot move to element. Then, so you can consider the example of there is a dropdown. When you mouse over the dropdown, automatically the dropdown will appear again. You want to go one more element, right? So that's so what will happen is move to element, there is a element, again I want to go one more element, so move to element, again element, then click I want to perform action on it and build.perform. So this will, these things will executed sequentially using the build, and this build will execute all the actions sequentially, then perform the action. So this build will sequence all the actions, and the perform will execute all together one by one. Right? So again, in automation framework, have you implement, have you called this several methods the same line? So these are the questions when you attend the interview in the product-based company. So these questions are asked to me when I'm attending the one product-based company recently. So that's what, see, these are the questions, all the questions I have taken from my experience whenever I'm attending the interview. So I will keep remembering all those questions, and so simply I will attend the interview to check my knowledge, how I am good at it. So I'm making those videos here. So here in automation framework, what I'm doing here, asserted, asset true. So here, if you do, when you write this line, what will happen is, it will create the object for the login page object class, and I'm calling the one method from this class. So instead of, we can write two lines, right? So we can create object in the one line. Using that object, we can call that method. So it requires two lines, after, then assert. So it requires three lines. So I'm reducing the three lines into the single line, right? So new login page objects dot driver. So what will happen? It will create the object, and I'm calling one method from the class, validate login. It will return on boolean value. I'm validating the boolean value inside this method. Right, so if they ask, have you called multiple methods in the same line? Yes, we can do it. So using the this concept, right? So I have given the explanation. We'll create the object for the, so this line. So this will create object for the login page objects, right? Object class, and we are calling the validate login method. We'll return the boolean value, and we are asserting that value, right? So the same line, we are explaining the this line, asserted assert true, new login page objects driver dot validate login, right? Okay, how we are implementing encapsulation in our framework? See, basically you should know what is encapsulation. So wrapping up of member data on member functions inside a single unit is called encapsulation. So member data, in the sense, you can take the example of page object class, right? So anyhow, you are very familiar with the page object class. So in the page object class, usually what we will do, so you have to remember that, right? So we are going to create member data, like see, you can take normal class. What are the things we'll have in the normal class? Member data and member functions inside the single unit. So from the definition only you can explain encapsulation, right? So encapsulation, you can take the example of that capsule, that it's plastic capsule. You can, I think you can able to remember that plastic capsule, which will be covered in the plastic, and inside we are having the drugs, right? So the drugs are member data and member functions. That outer cover you can take as the class, right? So in the inside the class, the drugs are member data and member functions covered by the class. This is called encapsulation. How we are covering, how we are keeping the drugs? So here you can take private. So we are making the member data as a private. So at find by XPath equal to private web element user ID, right? And my member methods. So I am accessing that private variable inside the public method. So here I can show you the difference. So private variables are not accessible outside the class. So I want to implement the encapsulation. So what I am doing is, inside the public method, I am accessing the private variable. This is called encapsulation, right? So This is what you need to explain. So you need to explain what is encapsulation, how we are implementing member data and member function. So we are creating as a private variable and we are accessing that inside the public method. This is what you need to explain. And this is one more question, like how to drag and drop the element from one frame to another frame. For this also recently I have released one video how to do. Okay, so the question is move element from one frame to another frame. So you can consider the page which contains two frames. So the frame one contains one element. I want to move that element to the frame two. So it's not very easy. If all the elements are available inside the same page, we can easily drag and drop, right? So what I'm going to do is, so I have created one method which is going to have source frame, means source name, ID, and my target frame, and web driver, source element, and target element, right? So anyhow, I need to move this element to the another element, right? So another element. So that's what I have, source element and target element, and source frame and the target frame. So I'm creating object for the action class. So here, switch to frame. So I'm having one method, switch to frame, when I send driver and source frame. So automatically, instead, if you have, we can convert also driver dot switch to source frame. So this is fine. Anyway, we can do that also. Again, we can copy and we can, instead of source frame, I want to make it as switch to target frame. Okay, this will make sense. Instead of creating the problem, I can, okay. So now I want to go to source frame. From the source frame, action dot move to element, the source element. Right, so now this line will go to the first frame, and inside the first frame I want to go to the source element and click and hold. So what I'm going to do, just I pressed that element, build dot perform. Okay, then just I'm keeping like that. Now I want to move to the target frame. So still that element got pressed, so the driver now will move to the target frame, and now the driver will focusing on the frame 2. And here I am writing action dot move to element target element dot release, which means that anyhow in the first frame I'm holding it and I'm dragging to the second frame, second element, and I am releasing there, right? So the build dot perform. So now that element is moved to the target frame. Then I am coming out from the all the frames. So now it will come to the default content, means it will come to the parent page, like that home page. It's not home page. It will come out from the frame. That's it. So we can use the default content as the method. Okay, this is one of the important interview question that will be asked in one of the product based company. Okay, so this is a little bit, it's very, sometimes this will be very easy. Sometime, if you are not prepared, you cannot answer, because these are the things we are using regularly. But when we are not, if you are not prepared, then you cannot. So that's what. So ways to refresh the page without using the context click. So I want to refresh the page instead of, without using the context click method. How we can refresh? So there are five ways. Is when we finding the element, we can say fkeys.f5. Then driver.navigate.refresh. Then driver.navigate.2, driver.getCurrentURL. So this method also will get the same URL and it will get refreshed. It will take the current URL, means that same page, it will get refreshed. Then driver.get current. So here navigate.2, here driver.get. driver.getCurrentURL. Finally, inside the find element, I'm using the ASCII code. that also will refresh the current page, right? These are the five ways, so you can able to answer. Finally, object repository. What is object repository? See, whenever you want to store the test data or your dynamic exports, right? You need some external source like Excel, text file, database, XML file, anything. So these, whatever I told, Excel, text file, database, XML file, or property file. So these five are the object repositories. So whenever you want to store something external sources, that is called object repositories. So you are going to take that data from the object repositories to the your test script. So this is called object repository. So today we have seen 10 questions, right? So first one is the kind of exception. So WebDriver exception, Selenium session not found exception, element not visible exception, no such frame exception, and no such window exception, right? So stale element reference exception, what is polymorphism, and compile time runtime polymorphism, and how that Selenium commands are converted into the browser commands. So how you are implementing interface. So here I have that for interface question, I have a video for it. And one more question is how we are calling the multiple methods. So it's a regular work basis we are doing it. And how we are implementing encapsulation, and how to drag and drop the element from one frame. So this also I'm having on video. Recently I have released that video. Then how you are refreshing the page, and what is the object repository. So these are the 10 questions we have seen today. Hope you like this video. Help others by subscribe, like, and share this video. Thanks for watching.